Let's start with a new project in Visual Studio. The first thing we want to do is find the MIP library template. The MIP SDK installer automatically installs the template, so we can locate it under Installed Templates in Visual C Sharp. If we scroll down to the end of the list, we see three MIP prefix templates. MIPLibrary is the one we are interested in for component integrations. For your reference, the template is in your Visual Studio directory under Templates and Project Templates. Let's go back to Visual Studio and select MIPLibrary and name this project Template Test. First, let's look at the graphical elements. It's basically just an empty window with a close button and an associated event handler in the code. Let's continue by looking at program.cs to see what happens at the beginning. At first, we must utilize the initialize method. This method is always used when interacting with the XProtect system. The other two initialize methods aren't necessarily needed, depending on the application requirements. If MIP UI elements are needed, then use that initialize method. The same applies for the export classes. If we go to the next code block, we see the Dialog Login Form class, and if we hover over it with the mouse, we see it's part of the UI. It is essentially the login form that will be presented when we run the application. So, in summary, it doesn't hurt to leave the initialize methods active, but if you don't need them, you should not initialize them. The login form will be presented first, and if the login succeeds, we then instantiate the main form. If we look at mainform.cs, we see the onClose event handler. When the application closes, we gracefully disconnect from the server. Let's run the application. We first see the login prompt, which looks similar to that of the management client. We also see the same authentication mechanisms as in all XProtect applications. Let's log into the local system. We see the application window, which means that the login worked. Back in designer mode, let's add two labels to indicate whether or not we are logged in. The first one will read "logged in." The other one will be initiated as "no." We change that in the if statement if we succeed at logging in. In mainform.cs, let's insert the if statement in the code. We are checking if we are logged in. The argument for the method is the URI of the management server. If it evaluates to true, we will modify the text of the second label. Let's try it out by running the application. It works just as expected.